Hi, Planter Sponge followers. I am Uriel Urquiza, and I'm a postdoctoral researcher working in the Cluster of Excellence for Plant Sciences. I work with Professor Matthias Zubrichen in the Institute for Synthetic Biology at the University of Düsseldorf. And today, I'm going to show you a short animation of the type of work we are doing here in the Institute using synthetic biology tools in order to get a better understanding of how plants operate internally. I hope you enjoy the animation.
Plants are very important for our societies, as they provide many services for us. They feed us, help us fight diseases, and brighten up our life day to day. Therefore, having a better understanding of their biology is of great importance for a sustainable future. And today, we are talking about a very new exciting approach for studying plants. We have learned over several decades of research that plants are very complicated at the molecular level. We also have concluded that what we have is just the tip of the iceberg. The importance of plants for our societies and the planet give us a responsibility for doing more research about their biology. Because, if we aim as society to ensure food security for our and future generations, we need to have solid fundamental knowledge of how plants work. This knowledge should start at the molecular level and scale up all the way into ecosystems including human societies and their associated economies. We can start by noticing that plants, unlike animals, cannot run away from danger. For example, they cannot move to a shady place for avoiding dangerous UV radiation. They cannot walk away into a different place if soil is poor or humidity is not right for them. They face even more challenges because weather can change rapidly. For example, cloudy skies versus clear ones. Therefore, they have to adjust their internal state for coping with these challenges. Like us, they have a very complicated network of molecules that allows them to perceive the environment. Plants' internal network use environmental information to respond and adapt. These molecular networks allow plants to be very plastic and adaptable. New technological breakthroughs might help us gain better understanding of plant molecular networks. In particular, I am very excited about a rapidly developing field of research called synthetic biology. This is a very exciting research area. Because after many years of scientific progress all over the world, we now know that plants and animals use very similar building blocks at the molecular level. And that both share very similar factories for producing their components. What is even more exciting is that they use the same type of molecule as a blueprint for making their components. You might have heard about this molecule. It is called DNA. And in this molecules is where the code for making an organism resides. You can imagine it as disk drive or a USB stick. However, the important lesson to be kept in your head is that it can carry information. We have learned over 70 years a lot about DNA. And in particular, we have learned how to read and write DNA. Thanks to these abilities, we have discovered some of the basic rules for writing meaningful biological information on DNA. Furthermore, as I mentioned earlier, the machinery for reading the genetic code is very similar between plants and animals. Therefore, we can execute code from plants in animal cells. We can do this in a very safe way under laboratory conditions. As we can grow animal cells in the lab. And this is a very powerful thing we can do for understanding how plants work. Because we can use animal cells as a clean canvas for executing plant code and see what happens. This helps to have more solid conclusions about how bits of DNA code operate. For example, we could be interested in testing, if we have all the basic information needed to create the scent of a flower. We can copy all the bits of information that we think are needed. Then introduce this information into animal cells and finally test if they produce the scent. If we manage to reproduce the smell, this will mean that our knowledge is complete. However, if we fail to do so, that will mean that we are missing some important pieces of the puzzle. In this last case, we can go back to the plant and look for other pieces of code that are important for the system. If we manage to obtain a functional transferred system, we can conclude that we have the minimal set of components required for the process to be functional. We call this approach reconstruction biology and it is a subfield of synthetic biology. Using this approach, we hope to understand much better how plants respond to the environment. In particular, how the molecules responsible for this response are doing it. Furthermore, because the information for making these molecules is coded in DNA, we can rewrite or edit the genetic code of plants. The aim in this is to improve them in a fast and safe way for agriculture. In order to achieve this modifications, we can use other tools from synthetic biology. One example is CRISPR, spelled C-R-I-S-P-R, and I encourage you to Google about it. Using this powerful synthetic biology tools, we aim as scientists, help on ensuring food security in the planet for feeding our generation and the new coming ones. Finally, I want to mention that both scientists and society in general have to come together to oversee the development of this technologies and invite you to engage broadly with us if you have any concerns about plant synthetic biology. Thanks for listening and see you around.